New York. Actually, I was, for a proper location, I was born in Brooklyn, New York, USA. And my parents lived in the Bronx, in the North Bronx. But my mother worked in Brooklyn, so I was born there in the hospital, and then I grew up in the Bronx. I think the instrument chose me. My older brother played drums very well. Steve Jordan is a drummer, you know, I'm sure. He lived around the corner from me, so our parents were very close. And Steve was always great since he was a kid. He's older than me, but I used to watch him practice. And he was on TV. Maybe by the time he was 18 or 19, he was already playing on television. So I was, it was inspiring to me. But I didn't take the drums seriously until I was about 16. Yeah. And that's when I started to study, take piano lessons. Play clubs, church, weddings, any place. On the street, in the park, everywhere.
Okay. Alors, how would you make Living Color for the members?
Okay. My first gig was with Harry Belafonte.
Yeah.
The gentleman who hooked me up with Harry Belafonte is from Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Every year, Brooklyn has an African street festival.
Okay.
And I was playing with the, not Harry Belafonte, but his band in the street festival with another singer. And Vernon was there, and we talked about maybe doing some stuff, and he gave me a tape. And I said, okay, no problem. And then he called me to do one show or two shows, and then we started the band.
Yeah, that's great. Hello. Do you remember the first show to Paris in Élysée Montmartre?
Yes.
It's great.
Paris was...
What do you think about the French audience?
Well, the French audience is great. It's very educated. Very educated about jazz. It's very educated about art and literature. So to come to Paris and growing up listening to jazz mostly, I'm familiar with Miles Davis' relationship with Paris, Dexter Gordon, Coltrane, Ben Webster, and a lot of musicians lived here, you know, moved here. Eric Dolphy, a lot of guys lived here. So as a young student learning, I wanted to come to Paris because I wanted to see why so many great musicians wanted to live here or be here. So it was attractive for me to come.
Yeah.
And then when I came to the show, there was so much to see. African musicians, you know, the museums. It's so much going on. My first day, I didn't sleep.
There's a mix everywhere.
Amazing. Yeah. Great food, everything.
Yeah. For me, in 17 September, we have the last show of BBQ to Paris. How did you meet him?
I met B.B. King through Vernon.
Yeah.
Vernon Reed was producing B.B. King's songs.
Yeah.
And he called me to play drums on the songs.
Yeah.
And that's how I personally met B.B. I mean, I saw him at shows, but I was formally introduced to B.B. Through Vernon Reed.
Which album?
They didn't put the songs on an album, it's on a box set.
Ow.
King of the Blues, box set, it's on the box set.
Ow. Hello. My friend, I would meet Marcus Miller, because Marcus, I've got Marcus 2 months ago.
Oh.
In the interview, the program for the record, French record company. Because business.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Hey, my pleasure, Marcus Bissot. Long time.
I mean, Marcus is a great human being. He's a fantastic musician. I know him from New York. I can tell you a funny story. At one point, when we were looking for another bass player, Muzzy wasn't playing bass anymore. I met Marcus. I know him many years, but I saw him at Miles Davis's funeral. So he said, what's going on? I said, man, we're trying to get a bass player for this Living Color in Brazil. And he said, I'll do it.
Which album?
I played on The Sun Don't Lie.
Yeah.
On one song.
Okay.
But we got Doug Wimbish, but anyway, yeah. if Doug wasn't available from London, we were going to use Marcus for the show.
Yeah. Okay, I remember that. You got many Grammy Awards, Berklee School of Boston. Talk to me a little bit. The Grammy Award, is it very important for you?
It's a very prestigious award in this business.
Yeah.
To be honest with you, I never picked up the sticks or wrote music to win any awards.
Yeah.
You know, I do it because I love it. On my new CD, Native Lands, on my new CD, DVD, there's a lot of research on the DVD. And I do it myself. I go to Africa, I stay with family, South America, Central America, you know, many places, because I love it. It's fantastic to win two Grammys. It's really great because it states the industry recognizes what you've done, but you can't make it part of your influence to do something because it can be like a drug if you're not careful. And you'll think, oh, I have to win, I have to lose, I don't want to lose. And to be honest with you, never for one second making any Living Color record that I think we were even going to make money. Or play for 1,000 people or 500 people.
Yeah.
The idea was to make great music.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm very respectful that I received the award from the industry.
Yeah.
And it is a prestigious award, yes. And I'm very happy to receive it. However, I don't let it control my musical psyche.
Mm-hmm.
I want to keep writing and playing and touring and making new music because I have so many great records in my collection at home that never won a Grammy. And they're fantastic records.
Yeah.
So you have to understand what it means.
Took me the project for Living Color maybe from December.
December is basically, we toured 3 weeks ago with Doug Pinnick of King's X singing lead.
Mm-hmm.
Because Corey is doing a play. He has a contract with a Broadway play.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't want to end the year with Living Color with a different singer.
Yeah.
It was fun, special edition Living Color with King's X singer. But we'd like to come back to Europe for 8 shows, something small, Paris, London, some parts of Switzerland, you know, Holland, and do it with Corey, just 1 week, and have some fun, and close the year, and try some new songs.
Yeah. Hello. Yesterday, I saw the show with Archie and Tidiane Seck. How did you meet them? I said, Tidiane, you like him.
It's fantastic. We met in Morocco. I met him in Paris, but we didn't get a chance to hang out. We hung out in the Ganawa Festival in Morocco. It was fantastic. Archie Shepp, I met through Pharoah Sanders, because when I come to Europe normally to play jazz, I tour with Pharoah Sanders. So Pharoah introduced me to Archie. We played the Frankfurt Jazz Festival in Germany. Archie played after us. So I had a chance to meet Archie. So I met him different places, but I arrived in Paris and I called my friends and I said, hey, Sheck is playing with Archie. So I called Sheck and he said, come to rehearsal. And I just got off the plane. So I went to rehearsal and hung out with the guys there.
This is a good supper, yes.
And his son, who I never knew, Archie's son, went to college. We went to college together.
Wow, okay.
This was a shock for me. I know him for 20 years and never knew that was his father.
Okay, hey, I am a son in 25.
There you go.
Hello. The good surprise for the clinic today in the Salon de la Musique, c'est which instrument on stage? Told me that.
The wind instrument.
Yeah.
it's a flute from southern China.
Yeah.
And I like to do it because it sounds, it's a very spiritual sound.
Yeah.
It's mixed with electronics. Mm-hmm. So even though it's a drum performance, I think music should be, it's sound.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, it's all sound.
So
the flute, the wave drum, the kick drum, some brushes, it's at the end of the day, it's sound. And I like to mix the sound. And I like to play with the flute sometimes because there's no time. It's very free. And it's a nice vibe. So I didn't know I was going to play it today. Sometimes I play, sometimes I don't. But
it's very cool because I took in the your foot.
Yeah.
And why?
Yeah.
It's very cool.
Thank you very much.
You also the show to Paris. What are your projects soon?
October 14th.
Yeah.
Native Lands Band. Marcus Strickland, saxophone,
mm-hmm.
Lauren Evans, piano,
yeah.
Mark Kelly, bass,
yeah.
Corey Wilkes, trumpet, myself.
Yeah.
We're gonna play the music from Native Lands.
Okay.
It's gonna be jazz, world music, urban, African. Yeah, it's not just straight ahead, it's all mixed together.
It's very cool.
Thank you very much, man. Merci
beaucoup. God bless you.
Blessings, man.